Wake up, Ireland.
I'm Colton.
And I'm Ian. Today is Monday, April 1st, 2024. We hope you had a relaxing and enjoyable spring break. Hey, Colton, what was your favorite thing you did over break?
I went skiing in Utah. I had a blast. How about you?
I also went skiing in Colorado. It was such a nice break. But I am ready to be back for the last quarter of the year. I can't believe it.
Me either. I really miss my friend, so I'm happy to be back. Welcome back, Ireland.
Today is National Nature Day. Nature is what we see outside every day, including plants, animals, the landscape, and other features and products of the earth, as opposed to humans or human creations.
It is important to get out and appreciate the nature around you you see every day.
Let's move on to birthdays. 1, 2, 3, 4. We have no birthdays today at Ireland. Check back in tomorrow.
Next up, what's cooking? And tomorrow for breakfast is cheese omelet with toast.
Today for lunch is option 1, chicken drumstick and breadstick. Option 2, sandwich bento box. Option 3, some butter and jelly. Your hot side is roasted broccoli.
Sounds delicious. Enjoy, and always remember to thank our wonderful staff who make our lunches here at Ireland.
It's Monday, so let's talk mindfulness. Today's strategy is called Happy Hum.
Good morning, Ireland. My name is Brooke. I will be doing the Happy Hum. First, you take a deep breath in, and instead of breathing out, you hum out until you lose all your air. Let's do that 3 more times. Bye.
Thanks. This strategy would be great to use if you're feeling frustrated, mad, stressed, or upset with someone or someone else.
Try using this technique next time you feel like you just can't handle your emotions. It's time for Monday Mysteries.
It's time for a reveal of who the Monday Mystery Book character thief is. Watch closely for the reveal to see if you are correct.
Thank you for your help in helping us capture the Jar Thief this week. Our most recent book character thief was the BFG, and here was his explanation. Lots of good dreams have been getting away lately, so I needed more jars to catch them. I can't let a fizz wizard get away. Big friendly giant.
I knew it.
Check back in next week for a new mystery book character thief. In other news,
we have a special announcement from Miss Bauer. Please listen carefully.
Good morning, boys and girls. Right now we're going to learn about a new spring drill that we need to practice. Due to the April showers that are approaching, the National Weather Service, the Department of Education, and the emergency management systems in the state have declared this week National Flood Emergency Awareness Week. All school classrooms are required to participate in a short flood emergency drill today. Classrooms across the country will be participating in this drill to make sure that all teachers and children are aware of what to do if a flood occurs. We will be participating in flood preparedness and school safety training. It is hoped that this short, thorough training and safety drill will increase teacher and student awarenesses and preparedness of any flooding situation. This drill is going to only take less than 5 minutes of important class time, and then all students will be able to return to your learning. So, right now, listen very closely as I read the directions to do this drill. Step 1. You may do this along with us, so I'll give you time. Step 1, students, please take off your socks and shoes and roll up your pants if necessary. This task should be completed in 60 seconds. You may begin. Teachers, go ahead and pause now and see how long it takes them to do that. And come back and hit play when they're ready. Step 2. Socks should be rolled or balled up and inserted inside the shoes, and then they should be placed under students' desks so they won't get wet. Make sure to do that. You don't want to walk around with wet socks all day long. Ready? Go. Teachers, please pause. All right, welcome back. Step 3. Standing drill number 1 is for short-term flooding safety. Students are to carefully stand on top of their chairs for a full 60 seconds. You need to do this carefully, and teachers, make sure the students are doing it as they are told. Those who cannot stand on top of their chairs safely should sit on their desktops and lift their legs as high as they can. Safely, boys and girls. Ready? Go. Step 4. Sitting drill number 2 is for long-term flooding safety. Students should sit back down in their chairs and put their feet up on their desk. They should get into a fully relaxed position that they could sit in for hours if necessary till any floodwaters recede. This drill should be ended after 60 seconds. Ready? Go. Step 5. When all flood drilling is done, students should put their socks and shoes back on and sit back down in their chairs before the teacher says, "April showers bring April fools."
That's all for today, everyone.
Have a magnificent Monday.
Be extra kind to one another.
Bye.